Hello guys and welcome to Vlogging Project. In today's video I'm gonna do a teardown of the new Nokia 3310 2017, and if you're wondering why does it look so funky, is because yesterday I've completed my bent, scratched and burned test. So today we're gonna take it apart and see if Nokia saved a little bit of money from the inside, because from the outside they definitely did. So the first thing we're gonna do, as you can see, that's a full working phone still. The first thing we're gonna do is remove the back cover. It could be a little bit hard to remove, so keep your fingertips long. The battery comes out relatively easily as well. And unfortunately we can see a 6 screws holding the front housing to the frame, unlike the old days of the Nokia, like the 7250, where they were heavily advertising the Express-On covers, where you basically just remove the cover like that, put the new one on and you're good to go. Unfortunately those days are over, so you have to suffer a little bit. So let me do these screws and I'm gonna come back in a sec. So that's the phone without the screws. Now let's see how we're gonna pop this one open. There are a couple of things that hold the frame. Let's see, we pry it off just like that. Over here we've got our speaker, there's the flash over here, this one is for the antenna lines here, nothing special really. And that's our main board, let's see how it is connected. We've got one connection over here, we're just gonna snap that like a little Lego. And that's our camera over here, as you can see it's quite miserable, so it doesn't really make sense to take it out at this point. So let's just use our fingernails to pop this baby open and see what do we have underneath. So that's it, there's the main board here. It's a little bit unfortunate to see that the SIM card tray has been soldered to the main board, as well as the micro USB charging port and the 3.5mm jack. So basically if any of those goes bust, you probably have to replace the main board, because it's gonna be too expensive for somebody to solder them back. And if you can do soldering, then it's not a problem, but it's definitely not for everybody. The keyboard actually comes out like that. It has one connector as well. I would say pretty straightforward to repair, to be honest with you. There's absolutely nothing complicated in this build. The keyboard is very easily replaceable. Let's have a look over here. Oh, actually that was our screen. That's interesting. Let's see how we're gonna do that without actually damaging the screen itself. Let's do it like that. I can see that there's just a little bit of glue, so be careful with taking the screen off. There we go. That's our beautiful screen over here. There's the face. Let's see if we can pop the keyboard open. There we go. That's an easy. I could have wished that they've implemented the fingerprint reader over here. It would have been awesome, don't you think so? And what else? Over here we've got the earpiece. And pretty much that's it. I mean, it's quite easy to repair, to be honest with you. All you gotta do, if you have a broken screen or something like that, just put the screen back over here. Let's see. Just like that. Be careful not to break it. I heard a crack, so let's see if I manage to break it. Put the keyboard back on. Put the main board over here. To be honest with you, I have no idea how they managed to build this phone so sturdy. I mean, there's no proper frame whatsoever, because that plastic frame, as you can see, is quite flimsy. The front fascia, the front housing is quite flimsy as well. So I have no idea how they managed to build this thing so strong. But anyway, let's put the small connector back on. Let's make sure you put the main board properly. What else? Put this thing back on. It snaps nicely like that. Let me put the screwdrivers back on and I'm gonna see you in a sec. Okay, all the screws are back on. So let's see if I managed to break the screen by accident or it's still gonna be working fine. Let's see what we have. Oh yes, we're back in the game. Let's check it out quickly. There's backlight. Working here, the screen seems fine. So even if you're not too careful, everything's gonna be okay. So yeah, not to worry, you can use and abuse your Nokia phone and not to worry about the housing, because I'm sure there will be some replacement parts available sooner or later, if not directly from Nokia, then third-party Chinese resellers or something like that. So yeah, that was it for today, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Hit the thumbs up if I helped you out with my video. Don't forget to check my full review and also my ultimate durability test of the Nokia 3310. So yeah, that's it for today. Thank you very much and see you later, guys. Bye.